Okay, we'll start today's session. So in this class, we are going to discuss about types of entrepreneurs and entrepreneurship development and few more aspects related to entrepreneurship. Okay, there are various criteria based on which we consider entrepreneurs. Okay, so in three different ways. Entrepreneurs may be classified on the basis of functional characteristics, personality types, or schools of thought. Okay, so we have to concentrate on entrepreneurs classification based on functional characteristics rather than personality types or schools of thought. Okay, so based on personality types, entrepreneurs may be classified as the improver, the advisor, the superstar, the artist, the visionary, the analyst, the fireball, the hero, and the healer. Okay, so this is based on personality. Okay, so what kind of personality so they have? Okay, and they advertise themselves in front of the world based on that. So we have these types of personalities or these types of entrepreneurs. Based on schools of thought on entrepreneurship, entrepreneurs are classified as belonging to the great person school of entrepreneurship. So in this case, so entrepreneurs it is based on intuitive ability, vigor, and good instincts of an entrepreneur or a person. Okay, what do you mean by intuitive ability? What do you mean by intuition? Intuition and analysis. Okay, so what do you mean by intuition and what do you mean by analysis? So intuition means, so if you take a sudden decision, okay, without analyzing its consequences, okay, that is considered as intuition. Okay, it is about taking decisions quickly without much analysis about upcoming consequences. Okay, vigor means it is the strength of an individual. So good instincts also, it is based on individual's capability and his instincts. Okay, if you take a decision, so that is considered as so great person school of entrepreneurship. It is based on individual's capability to make decisions. Okay, next, the psychological characteristics school of entrepreneurship. So here, psychological characteristics of human being is considered the classical school of entrepreneurship, focusing on the innovative streak. That means a person who thinks, who is coming up with new ideas. Okay, that will be considered. Innovative streak is nothing but innovative line of thinking. Innovative streak in entrepreneurs. Next, the management school of entrepreneurship, focusing on the idea of creating entrepreneurs by training them to be good managers, like providing management education. Okay, so we have IIMs, which are famous for people who want to pursue their education in management stream. Okay, they want to be in the IIMs. Okay, so it is famous for quality education in the field of management, like that. So there are many business schools or management schools, okay, so which will train students to become entrepreneurs. The leadership school of entrepreneurship, focusing on leadership qualities of entrepreneurs. So even this course, you are studying this course as part of getting some exposure related to entrepreneurship. Okay, after your graduation, after working in some company for few years, then you may be willing to start your own business. So then you may need some theoretical background regarding how to start a business, what are the considerations, what are the consequences, in order to understand that. So this course will help you. So next, the intrapreneurship school of entrepreneurship, focusing on developing entrepreneurial traits in managers in an organization. Okay, this is about training the managers to become entrepreneurs. Okay, so managers already working in the company. Okay, so if it is possible to train them to start business of their own. So that is considered as entrepreneurship school of entrepreneurship, training inside the company to start a business of their own. Next, based on functional characteristics, entrepreneurs are classified as innovative entrepreneur. Okay, innovative entrepreneurs are innovative in their approach to business and introduce new products, new production methods, or discover new markets or new forms of organization in their enterprise. Okay, so one such example is this person. Okay, so what is the name of this person? Who is he? What is the name of this person? What is the name of this person? Right. Okay, so who is he? Muhammad Tafim.
Sir.
So who is this person in photograph, in image?
Don't know, sir.
Okay, so any others? So recently, so there was a Tamil film about an entrepreneur from Karnataka. It is also a famous movie.
Yes, sir.
What is the name of this person? Who is this entrepreneur?
Sir, Captain Gopinath.
Okay. So you can consider him as innovative entrepreneur. What he did? He established...
Sir, he gave cheap rate.
Okay. So he started aviation company called Air Deccan, which provides services to passengers at cheaper price compared to his competitors. Okay. So he started Air Deccan. So that journey he wrote in his book, Deccan Odyssey. You can read that book. Even the film, it is not exactly based on his life, but it is inspired by his life. Okay, you can, you might have watched that film. Okay, Surai Potru, I think. I don't know the actual pronunciation. Okay. So he identified, you can consider him as an innovative entrepreneur. The reason is he discovered new market. So how he discovered new market is he identified that people, middle class people, okay, so who cannot invest more money on traveling in planes or in the airlines, okay. So if we are able to reduce cost of air travel, okay, so we can accommodate those people also. Then he tried to reduce so ticket prices of planes, okay, so that is providing services at least cost. Okay, so then he succeeded in that also. Okay, after few years of operating, later he sold that firm to another airlines. Okay, so who bought Air Deccan?
So Kingfisher.
Okay, so who bought this firm? Okay, after a few years of its operation, he sold Air Deccan to Kingfisher Airlines. Okay, now, so both are, you cannot see both airlines. Okay, so after a few years of operation, he sold Air Deccan to Kingfisher. That is, Vijay Mallya bought this company. Okay. So next, imitative or adaptive entrepreneur. So imitative means, so they will imitate instead of coming up with their own idea. So they will identify a successful business which is already in the market. They try to imitate. Okay, they try to adopt. So that is also possible. Entrepreneurs belonging to this category imitate products, production methods, and new forms of organization in their enterprise. Okay, so most of the Chinese companies are famous for imitation. Okay, so they are able to produce a lot of products at very least cost. Okay, so they will imitate. If there is a product from a brand company, immediately Chinese companies will produce a similar product which costs less. Okay, those companies are examples for imitative or adaptive entrepreneurs. Okay, so this category of entrepreneurs can be found especially in developing and underdeveloped countries, partly due to a lack of investment in research and development. Okay, so even in most of the developing countries like India, okay, underdeveloped countries also, you can find imitative or adaptive entrepreneurs. The reason is, if government is not spending enough money on research and development and R&D, okay, so then it is difficult to come up with new technologies, new innovations, new methods. Okay, so in the absence of all these, so there is scope for this imitation. So that's why in developing and underdeveloped countries, so you can find many companies which imitate the successful products from well-established firms. Okay. Even if you consider, okay, vaccine manufacturing. Okay. So Serum Institute is famous for this. Okay, they produce a lot of generic medicines which cost less. Okay, and how they will manufacture is, so some after the patent of some vaccine has expired, okay, they will follow the procedure to manufacture a particular vaccine. Okay, then they start its production. They are famous for producing most of the generic medicines. Okay, so that is an example of imitative or adaptive entrepreneur. Next, Fabian entrepreneur. Fabian entrepreneurs are not proactive in nature and do not respond very much to changes in the environment. Instead, they change only when there is a threat to the existence of their enterprise. You can see some business organizations. Okay, so from 50 or 60 years, so they will be having the same business model. They don't upgrade. Okay, so they will run the business as usual and as it is. So sometimes they go for modification only when there is a threat for their existence. Some competitor will start a similar business, and if consumers shift towards competitor, so then they go for upgrading their operating procedure. Okay, that is the Fabian entrepreneur. Next, drone entrepreneur. So drone entrepreneurs are conservative and complicit in nature and like to maintain the status quo. These entrepreneurs may incur losses and have to close down their enterprises. Okay, so they live a lavish life, a luxury life, at the cost of the whole company. Okay, so they don't learn from their mistakes. They want to have get more publicity. They want to be in news always. Okay, for that they will live a luxury life. They will project themselves in different ways. Okay, so who is the best example for this type of entrepreneur, drone entrepreneur, where company is in loss and company has closed down, but the boss of that company is still living lavish life. Okay, who is the example for this type of entrepreneur?
Vijay Mallya.
Okay, Vijay Mallya. Okay, so now So Kingfisher is in huge crisis. Okay, so employees lost their job, but Vijay Mallya is living luxurious life in England. Okay, and he has to pay more than 9,000 crores. He has to repay that loan to banks. Then also he is living a luxurious life in England. So not only Vijay Mallya, so there are few more entrepreneurs like Nirav Modi, Mehul Choksi. Okay, so our governments, so they fail to take actions against these people. Okay, so they might have supported these people by getting other favors. That is also possible. Okay, next, development of entrepreneurship or the process of entrepreneurial development. That means how people can be motivated to start their own business. Okay, so that is the development of entrepreneurship. It is about developing entrepreneurial traits or creating interest among people about starting their own business. Okay, so it is about how it is possible to motivate people to start their own business. What is the procedure or what are the initiatives that government or educational institutions or even industrial training centers can take to encourage people to start their own business. That is about development of entrepreneurship. It is about motivating people to become entrepreneurs. So that is the process of entrepreneurial development. The process of helping a person to develop into an entrepreneur includes three phases. First is stimulatory phase. This involves implementing stimulatory activities for creating interest and awareness in potential entrepreneurs. Okay, so the introduction of this course is part of the stimulatory phase. Okay, in order to create interest and in order to provide theoretical framework that is required for any person who want to start a business in the current situation of global competition, this course is introduced. Okay, so after studying this course, you will have at least some knowledge regarding how to manage people, how to manage a company, how to start your own business, what are the challenges, okay, and what are the opportunities in front of you, and how you can make use of these aspects or these concepts to start your own business. So you will have some knowledge. That knowledge will be provided by this course, and this is also part of stimulatory phase. Stimulatory activities include planned publicity for entrepreneurial opportunities. Okay, for example, so our government has took few initiatives. They might have it may be successful or it may be a failure. That is a different discussion. But government has few projects. Okay, so like Make in India, Startup India. Okay, these are the initiatives taken by government to encourage people to become entrepreneurs. Okay, similarly in MC also there's a project to make students encourage to become entrepreneurs. Which is that project?
Make in MC.
Okay, if you have a new idea in your mind, okay, you can give a project proposal and you will get funds. Okay, even in MIRISE also, if you have a very good innovative idea, you can give project proposal, and you can, if during your graduation, you can work on that idea. Okay, if you are able to come up with a product, in future, you can start your own business based on that. Okay, so if you are having innovative ideas, so you can approach people who are in charge of making MCE or MIRISE. Okay. For MIRISE, you can contact Nitin sir in our department. He is the coordinator. Okay, so if you have innovative ideas, so contact him. You can give project proposals now itself, and you can get funding up to 3 lakhs. Okay, if your project is proposal is accepted for implementation, you will get all financial backup, okay, up to 3 lakhs. So that is also part of stimulatory phase to encourage students to become entrepreneurs, to start their own business. Okay, next, providing entrepreneurial education, like introducing courses like this one. Next, counseling and motivational training to new entrepreneurs. Okay, so this can be provided by people who are already successful in running business enterprises. Okay, they can do counseling, they can guide you. Okay, so there are some organizations which will provide this type of motivational training and counseling. Next, identification of potential entrepreneurs through scientific techniques. So like making MC, so first they will call for project proposals. Okay, so that is the scientific approach. So what is your idea, whether your idea is feasible or not, make based on that. So they will evaluate the proposals, then they will select few and they will reject unworkable business concepts. Okay, next, providing guidance. Okay, next, in selection of product or service and preparing project reports, creating entrepreneurial forums and recognizing and rewarding existing entrepreneurs. Okay, so there are many institutions, okay, which will give awards for entrepreneurs. So all these are part of stimulatory activities. Next, support phase. In stimulatory activity, it is possible to create awareness and interest among people to start their own business. Okay, now people are motivated to start their own business. So only motivation doesn't hold good to be an entrepreneur. Okay, so there are still more backup is required. It may be from the government, or it may be from the educational institutions, or it may be from the business sector itself. Okay, so that is the support phase. This involves implementation of support activities that help in new venture creation. Now you have a business idea, you got motivation to start your own business because of the stimulatory activities. Now you want to start your own, that means you want to convert your plan into reality. Okay, that is the support phase. Now you need support from government, support from other institutions, which will give financial support and even conceptual support. Okay, support activities nurture and promote entrepreneurship. Support activities are registration of enterprises. So that means if you want to start your own business, then you have to register. Okay, so if government provides support, if government guides you how to register your enterprise, so that also a part of developing entrepreneurship. Next, development of the product prototype, arrangement of finance, land, shed, power and common facility center, offering management consultancy services and market support, guidance for selecting plant and machinery and getting approvals and licenses. Okay, if you want to start any business, it includes a lot of activities. Okay, starting from taking permissions from various government departments. Okay, that is the major problem for most of the businessmen. Since our system is very corrupt, it is difficult to get approvals. Even though legally you may have followed all procedures, even after that also, because of corruption in the bureaucracy and in the political class, it is difficult to get approvals. And if you don't give bribe, okay, so if you don't give money, so then they will delay, they will don't give you enough permission. It may be from, you have to take permissions from different boards related to pollution, you have to take permission, okay, and even from fire department also you have to take permission. Okay, so like that, depending on the type of business you are, and even if you are starting a hotel or other businesses, you have to take permissions from local authorities. Okay, and even food inspectors will visit quite often they will conduct raids. So there are many tortures provided by this procedure. So that's why many people idella act risk beku ee janjatane beda anta heli, so they will get demotivated because of the situation in the in our system, because of corruption, because of the many problems. Okay, so if a government is willing to stimulate or encourage entrepreneurship, okay, it has to create an environment where there is no corruption is an ideal thing, but it should be to the maximum extent it should be reduced by having some procedures. Okay, if our policy makers if they really wanted to reduce corruption, there are many ways, but they don't want to, okay, so do that. That is the problem. And again, this is always a problem for any entrepreneur, this corrupt system, okay, and red tape systems. That means when you go to government offices, they will give one or another reasons and they don't give you required permissions. So these are the consequences. Next, by going through all these challenges, if you are able to start your own business, you have an idea, so you got motivated in the stimulatory phase where government supported you and you got proper education regarding how to start a business and all those things, how to manage it. Next, in the next phase also, support phase, you got government support to register without much problems, okay, to get all approvals. Now you have started a business. Next, if you start business, it doesn't end there. That is the beginning of a new journey. Next, you have to ready with challenges. That means in order to survive in the market, okay, so you have to do a lot of circus, okay, so it is a continuous process. So that is sustenance phase. So now how you can sustain in the market, okay, so bagla mudde tara yatra nadaskond hogadu on company na, okay, that is about sustenance phase. This involves the implementation of sustaining activities that help in the continuous and efficient functioning of enterprises within a society. Sustaining activities are modernization, diversification, expansion, getting additional finance and research and development support to help an enterprise survive, develop and grow after it is set up. Okay, modernization is about adopting new technologies, upgrading the existing system. Diversification is shifting from one product to another product. Okay, that is the diversification. Like during the crisis of this pandemic, you have seen many companies have shifted from one product to another product. Okay, most of the textile companies, okay, they shifted from their products to like masks instead of producing t-shirts, okay, pants. So they shifted towards masks. So that is diversification, considering the demand in the market. Even some companies started producing the sanitizers, face shields. Earlier they were not in that business. Immediately by looking at the demand for these products, they started producing masks, face shields, sanitizers. Even some companies which provide automation solutions, they started producing this automatic sanitizer dispensers. Okay, so this is about diversification. By looking at the needs of the market, if you come up with new products, that is diversification, so that you can sustain, you can be in the business. Next, expansion. Okay, so you can expand from, if you have one plant now, you can start new plant in some other location. Like that, depending on the demand for your product, you can go on starting new plants, expanding your business organization. Next, getting additional finance. Okay, so when yours is a startup, in order to expand, so you need additional finance. That finance can be availed by many ways. Taking loan is one way, or you can sell your shares, or you can call for venture capitalists. So they will invest on your business. Okay, that is getting additional finance. Research and development support to help an enterprise survive. Again, in order to come up with new products, so there must be a R&D department. So there are people who are working, always working about how to improvise an existing product and how which products they can start in upcoming years. Okay, that is the R&D. So develop and grow after it is set up. So these are part of sustaining activities. Okay. Next, stages in entrepreneurial process. So that means if you want to start your own business, okay, what is the procedure you need to follow? Or if you are an entrepreneur, what are the things that you have to do as an individual? What are the things you need to do that we discuss in stages in entrepreneurial process? Okay, first, generating business ideas and identifying business opportunities. Okay, this is one of the first step in entrepreneurship. Okay, if you don't have an idea, okay, so yav business start madbeku yenu madbeku anade gottilla andre, so it will end there itself. If you have an idea, okay, so nan intad madbeku, intha business start madbeku, idu madbeku, so idu madidre yen agutte, okay, so how I can start this business, how I can make profit. So this is the initial stage. Next, which business, whether it should be a manufacturing company or it should be a service company or it can be other businesses like starting a hotel, okay, starting a homestay. So all those comes under even service sector. Okay, if it is a manufacturing company, which type of product? Okay, so then or whether you are producing a single product, single component. Okay, so these are the things. So that is the first step, generating business ideas and identifying business opportunities. A business opportunity is a favorable set of circumstances that creates a need for a new product, service, or business. Business ideas may be generated in the following ways. One is observing trends. Okay, so trends in the society, social and economic trends, technological developments, and political and regulatory changes often create opportunities for entrepreneurship. Okay, so if you want to be in, if you want to become an entrepreneur, first thing what you have to do is, first you have to understand what is happening around you, what is happening in the society. That means every day you have to read newspapers. That is the basic requirement to be an entrepreneur, is to be aware of the policies of the government, to be aware of market conditions, to be aware of what is happening in the society. Without this primary understanding, you cannot run any business. Okay, so that is the primary requirement. You should understand social and economic trends. Okay, social trends, the lifestyle of people will change. Okay, if you look at the lifestyle 20 years before and now, lifestyle of your parents and lifestyle of yours, there is a lot of difference. Okay, so you have to understand that the needs of millennials are different from the needs of people who born before 1990. Okay, so you have to consider all these things, and you have to consider the mindset of people. Okay, it will change because of various reasons. That you must be able to understand. That is the social and economic trends. Economic trend means it is the state of economy. Now you know the economic trend of our country. It is in very bad situation. Okay, so now also we are in a, for the second consecutive quarter, we are in negative GDP. So still we are in minus 7.5. okay, and if there are negative GDP for two quarters, it is considered as technical recession. Now we are in technical recession. Upcoming consequences are very severe. We don't know what is going to happen in future. Okay, so we are becoming hopeless day by day by looking at the by our policy makers. They don't have any idea, so they are busy with a lot of foolish things. So they don't know how to manage our economy. That is the state of current state of affairs. Okay, in this situation, it is difficult to promote entrepreneurship. If the economy doesn't perform proper, people will lose confidence to start their own business. That is the problem. Okay, next, technological developments. Next, political and regulatory changes often create opportunities for entrepreneurship. The example is, you know, the conflict between India and China. Okay, if government imposes some restrictions on China, it will be adding some positive impact on some entrepreneurs, at the same time negative impact on some entrepreneurs. Both are possible. Okay, people who are dependent on raw materials supplied from China, they will get affected if impositions are if restrictions are implemented. Okay, so then they are in trouble. At the same time, it will create opportunity for some entrepreneurs, so they can start producing those materials or those products supplied from China. Okay, they can find an immediate opportunity. Okay, so that is based on political decisions. And one example for social trend is like more women entering paid employment create the need for more child care centers. Okay, if more number of women go for working, so then there's a requirement for child care centers. Okay, this is one social trend. Like that, there are many trends. If you look at the types of products earlier, so most of the prejudices regarding products used by women has changed now. Okay, earlier we have separate bicycles for women, separate bikes for women. Now trend has changed. They are able to ride even bullet bikes or even super bikes. Okay, women are capable, are there, they come up with, come out of this prejudice. Okay, so of riding different bicycles. Okay, so trend has changed. By looking at that trend, you have to come up with new products. So that is the social and economic trends. Okay, next, finding gaps in the market, that is a lack of a product or service in the market, creates an opportunity for entrepreneurs. Okay, so you can consider the example of Baba Ramdev. Okay, so he wears saffron, but he is a successful entrepreneur. Whether he do legal things or illegal things, that is different. Okay, whether he is involved in fraud or not, that is different discussion. I don't go for that. That is in the public domain. You can read what Patanjali did and okay, so what is happening, you know that. But so he is good at identifying this gap in the market. Okay, so he is good at that, finding gaps in the market. This Patanjali is good at finding gaps in the market. That's why they are able to make a lot of money in very short span of time. Recent development was, so when there is no vaccine for corona, okay, so when throughout the world many laboratories involved in developing vaccine for corona, so these people say we discovered a vaccine, if you take this it will cure corona. So they will advertise like that, and they immediately they released a product. Okay, which is the name of that product? From Patanjali, for corona. What is its name?
Coronil.
Okay, now do you have any proof to say that by consuming Coronil this number of patients get cured? There is no scientific evidence, there is no proof. If Coronil is a successful vaccine, why people are still working in laboratories for day and night by investing crores of rupees? Why they are doing this circus? If this Patanjali is successful in coming up with this vaccine, why people still, so they are working day and night? So that means what Baba Ramdev and his firm did, it is definitely a fraud. okay, they mislead the entire nation. And they, by looking at the opportunity, that is, there is no vaccine. They started, we have vaccine. There is no proof for that. But they find an opportunity that if we market a product as vaccine for corona, which will boost immunity and all those things. So we can sell and we can earn money. By looking at this gap, so they come up with that corona. Okay. So similarly, even you know the fraud committed by some of the companies, including Patanjali in Ani. Okay, I think we discussed in previous class. So they have adulterated Ani. Okay, they are selling sugar syrup as Ani. Okay, so these are the consequences. But what you can learn from this is, so even finding this gap plays a very important role in business. Okay, but I don't suggest you to commit all frauds like that. And even if you don't have political backup, you cannot survive. Why Ramdev can survive even after committing frauds like this is, he is having a political backup. Okay, so as a layman, if you do these types of mistakes, these type of frauds, you will be in jail. But for Ramdev, so there are other things. I don't go much into that. You cannot, if you look at what is happening around you, you can realize. Okay, so but as a layman, always you must go in a legal way. Otherwise, you will face a lot of consequences. Okay, only few people who are having political backup, so they can do like this circus and they can earn money. That is a different thing. Okay. Next, conducting a feasibility analysis. Okay, if you go for, if you are thinking about any business decision, whether I can introduce this product to market. If I introduce this product, am I able to earn profit? That is one major consideration. ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ನ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದರಿಂದ ನಿಮಗೆ ಲಾಭ ಬರುತ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡ್ರೇಷನ್. ಅನದರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡ್ರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್, ಆ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ನ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೇನು ಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಖರ್ಚಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಮೆಷಿನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು, ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಬೇಕು, ಎಷ್ಟು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಬೇಕು, ಎಷ್ಟು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಎಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡು ನನ್ನ ಕೈಲಿ ಹೊಂದಸಕ್ಕಾಗುತ್ತಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಿಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ economic feasibility. Financial feasibility is about whether you have money to start a business. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ದುಡ್ಡಿದ್ಯಾ, ಬೇಕಾಗೋಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡಿದ್ಯಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಿಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ದುಡ್ಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೂ ಅವ್ರಿವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಸಾಲ ತಗೊಂಡು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗುತ್ತಾ? ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಫಿಸಿಬಲ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಫ್ ಮನಿ, ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಫ್ ಮನಿ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಎ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಫಿಸಿಬಲ್. ದೆನ್ ಸೊ ನೀವು ಸಾಲಗಿಲ್ಲ ತಗೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ನೌ ಬೈ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅರ್ನ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅರ್ನ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕಲಿ ಫೀಸಿಬಲ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಇವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಫೀಸಿಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್, ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಫೀಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್, ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಸಕ್ಸೀಡ್ ಇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಫೀಸಿಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಮೋರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, so feasibility analysis is the process of determining the validity of a business idea. It includes market analysis, technical analysis, financial analysis, that is financial feasibility. Economic analysis is nothing but economic feasibility. Ecological analysis is, okay, most of the times we neglect ecological consequences. Okay, how much pollution your company may cause. So most of the times, most of the business firms, they are least bothered about ecological consequences. But if you are running a business where the policies of that particular government focuses on ecological considerations, then you must be worried about that also. Okay, some countries, they follow these things strictly. In some companies, they may compromise. Okay, so but being a sensible person, okay, so whether government will worry or not, being a sensible person, you must be worried about ecological consequences. Okay, being a responsible entrepreneur, you must be worried about ecological consequences of your product or your business. Okay, for that you have to do ecological analysis. Next, market analysis. Again, you have to analyze what is the demand, how much you have to produce. Okay, whether there is a demand for your market or not, who are the competitors, whether you can survive, all those are comes under market analysis. Technical analysis is about availability of technology, okay, and which technology you have to implement in your company. Next, making a business plan. A business plan is a written document, typically 20 to 30 pages in length, which describes what a venture intends to accomplish and how it plans to achieve its goals. Okay, if your objective, suppose if you want to start a manufacturing company, you want to produce fuel injectors. Okay, so you may be supplying that to another automobile company. So next, you have to make a plan based on that. Your goal is to produce fuel injector. Next, your goal may be to produce it at less cost. Okay. So for that, you have to prepare a detailed plan. Okay, what are the technologies you are using to produce this fuel injector, and from where you are procuring raw materials. Okay. So who are the customers, or for which companies you are supplying these fuel injectors? So all this comes in this business plan. It enables company to develop a roadmap to follow in executing its strategies. Another advantage of having a clear business plan is by showing that business plan, you can take investments. Okay, so if someone is having confidence in your business plan, he may invest. Okay, so you can get investment if you have very good business plan. Nanatra inta danda idea ide adanna execute madodakke nanatra ishtu dud shortage ide. So like that, if you approach someone who is having enough money, so if you have a good business plan, so you may agree to invest in your business idea. Okay, that is the advantage of having good business plan. It also provides the business model of the firm. Business model andre, so kharch eshtu agutte, labha eshtu barutte, labha heng madabodu, so that is the business model. So no company, okay, so want to be in loss. Yaarigu loss madkolakke ishta iralla, loss madkondro jaasti dina nadesakku agalla. That's why business model is like a mathematical model. Okay, so this much investment for, okay, so you have to add profit. You have to make what is the investment, what is the profit, and what are the upcoming challenges. By looking at that, you have a business model. So if you have proper business model, so that will always keep you in profit. That is good for the business. Then you can sustain. Next, arranging funds. Okay, so the two most common sources of funding for a venture are equity and debt financing. Equity financing means if you are registered in the stock exchange, you can sell shares and you can get investment. Okay, so that is the equity financing. That means by selling part of your ownership in terms of shares, you can take a fund, you can get money for investment. Debt financing is taking loan from bank and taking loan from non-banking firms like NBFC. Okay, so they will also provide financial assistance for businesses. Equity financing means exchanging ownership in a firm for funding. The various forms of equity financing are angel investing, venture capital, private equity, personal savings and investment from family and friends. Angel investing means, so angel investing is if you have money, okay, so an investor is having money and is ready to take risk. When most of the people reject your business plan, when most of the people are not ready to invest on your business, if someone come to take that risk, he is called as angel investor. Okay, angel like consul yaro bande yen sahaya martare antiyalva aa tara. So when most of the investors are rejecting your proposal, if someone come as a savior, so he is considered as angel investor. That is considered as angel investment. Next, venture capital. So again, it is about if you are successful, so then they will get confidence that if you invest, will get profit. That is venture capital. So venture capitalists will invest on successful firms. They are not ready to take much risk, whereas angel investors are ready to take risk. Okay, that is the difference between these two. Next, private equity, by again selling shares, personal savings, investments from family and friends. In debt financing, money is borrowed to run a business. The various forms of debt financing are funding through bank loans, financial institutions, and even credit cards also you can use. Okay, next, in order to understand the importance of getting funds to survive, you can watch this video. Okay, so recently Reliance has purchased two startups. One is from Bangalore. Okay, so why the startups decided to sell themselves to Reliance, what are the consequences, all those things is explained in this video by a business journalist. Okay, you can watch this video, you'll understand the importance of financing to survive. Otherwise big players will purchase you. Okay, setting up an enterprise and building a venture team. A venture team is made up of the people who will transform an idea of a venture into fully functioning firm. While setting up an enterprise, it is important to ensure smooth management of the enterprise, nurturing growth and exit strategies. Okay, so this is the last step. Some businesses, okay, during starting their business itself, they will decide, okay, so after 5 years, I want to sell this business. After 10 years, I will sell it. The example is Air Deccan. Okay, Captain Gopinath started Air Deccan, and he ran that business firm successfully for few years. Then he sold that to Kingfisher Airlines. So that is his strategy. Similarly, if you consider a Kannada newspaper, okay, Vijay Karnataka. Who is the owner of Kannada newspaper Vijay Karnataka now?
Vijay Sankeshwar.
So Vijay Sankeshwar, actually he started Vijay Karnataka. Okay, now is after few years he sold Vijay Karnataka to Times Group. Okay, Times of India Group is owning Vijay Karnataka now. That is his exit strategy. He started Vijay Karnataka, then he sold that to Times Group. After selling that time, so there will be an agreement. Okay, so neevu ಇಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗೋಪಿನಾಥ್ ಆರ್ ಈವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಿಜಯ ಸಂಕೇಶ್ವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ವಿಜಯ ಸಂಕೇಶ್ವರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ವಿಜಯವಾಣಿ, ನೌ ಈಸ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಫ್ಯೂ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಜಿ ಲೈಕ್, ಸೊ ಅವ್ರ ಜೀವನ ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಒಂದೇ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ರೆಡಿ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ಒನ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್, ಬೈ ದಟ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಕೆಲವ್ರು ನಡ್ಸೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಕೆಲವರು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಲಾಭ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಟಜೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್